from a broken sky, traced out by the city lights. My world from a mile high, best seat in the house tonight. Touchdown in the cold black top, hold on for the sudden stop. Breathing the familiar shock of confusion and chaos. Are those people going somewhere? Why have I never cared? Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. 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 Step out on a busy street, see a girl and our eyes meet. Does her best to smile at me, to hide what's underneath. There's a man just to her right, black suit and a bright red tie. Too ashamed to tell his wife he's out of work, he's buying time. Are those people going somewhere? Why? Give me your brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. 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 I've been here a million times, a couple of million eyes, just moving past me by. Never thought that I was wrong. Well, I want a second glance, so give me a second chance to see the way you've seen the people all along. Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Give me your eyes, Lord, give me your eyes so I can see for everything that I keep missing. Give me your heart for the brokenhearted. Give me your heart.
We'll be right back. This world can be cold and bitter. Feels like we're in the dead of winter, waiting on something better. But am I really gonna hide forever? Over and over again, I hear your voice in my head. Let your light shine, let your light shine for all to see. And start a fire in my soul, fan the flame and make it grow. So there's no fire in me. You only need a spark to start a whole blaze. It only takes a little faith. Let it start right here in this city. So these old walls will never be the same.
Do you need closed captioning for Facebook Live videos? Click on the Settings tab, turn on the captions, and then you'll see them pop up in just a few seconds on the left-hand side. It's that easy to turn on closed captioning.
Hello and welcome to New Way Online. I'm so glad you joined us today. To start things off, use the chat window and tell us who you are and who you are with. While you're at it, let us know what city, state, and country you're watching from. We have people from all over the world connecting with us. Throughout the service, we'll be putting links in the chat window, fun facts, scripture references, and more. We also like to chat with you. Yes, even during the service. And Pastor Keith might just ask you for your input as well. So be ready. Again, I'm so glad you joined us online today. How great is this? Online church, PJs, comfy chairs, isn't technology wonderful? Now, some New Way updates. Hello and
well, good morning, everyone. It is good to see you this morning. What a gorgeous day. It's supposed to be a high of almost 70 degrees, if not 70. But thank you so much for joining us this morning. And it doesn't matter where you're tuning in from, it's great to see you this morning. So my name's Keith Brown. I'm the pastor here at New Way. And we got the crew ready. Our crew today is Johnny Pappas back at the soundboard. Nathan Richardson's running our tech. Then we got Mark and Dustin back here behind me running our worship team. So. What's that?
Oh, no, nice talk.
All right. And this is quite the crew, trust me. That's it, my friends. That's it. We've got five people here. We're practicing our social distancing, but we're so excited to bring you worship this morning. So let me give a shout out to a bunch of people. Man, I'm trying to keep up with you. So many of you are watching, but here's some names. Look at the list of names already I've got here. So I'm so glad you're joining us this morning. So I'm going to say hi to Kathy and Don, Connie, Wendy and Tom, I see you. Jenny, Jennifer, see you down there in Ironton tuning in, right? The Barcrofts from Mansfield, Paul, Steve, Joan, and Kelly, the Grossmans, the Pappas family, Joy, I see you. McKees, Jody, the Boatsmans are watching. Tara, Denise, Amy, the Dyer, Shannon, Amy McNeely, Amy Sleuths, the Andersons are watching. Heidi, I see you out there. Krista's all the way coming in to us from Texas, so good to see you. Krista's, Wendy, Marie, Darla, the Pelosi's are watching. My daughter's Grace is watching. Hi, Gracie there. Katie is watching as well, too. Like I said, I can't even keep up. My friend Dustin is watching, too. Okay, yeah, he's watching. All right, good deal. Go to the stream and hit share. Share this to your timeline. Stay with us though. Don't start a watch party because then we lose track of people. So if you would in the chat window, make sure you say who's watching with you. So if you got a couple people in your house, that way it just kind of lets us know how people are doing. We're trying to keep track of you. Okay. So do that. Also let us know where you're watching from. Canton, Ohio, Dallas, Texas, wherever it is. All right. So because it's really fun, we're making some unique connections we've never made before, and so we want to do that. So list that in there as you're watching today. So I've got a couple announcements for you. We have a YouVersion Bible app. That is a free app with the Bible on it, but it also has New Way information in it. So download it, install it, and then if you click more events, and then if you search for New Way, New Way pops up. I have the worship program in there. I have links to our website, to the online giving. There's a new Bible reading plan I just put in there, a devotional plan as well. So that's free, and that way you have New Way info with you all the time. So check that out. This is Celebration Sunday. So every first Sunday of the month, we celebrate birthdays, new jobs, anniversaries, anything worth celebrating, okay? I know this month is graduation for a lot of people. Next Sunday is graduation Sunday. We have four seniors. I'm going to have an interview with them, and we're going to talk to them about graduation and the future, okay? So that's next Sunday. So anything celebration you want me to lift up, put it in the comments. I'll be watching it over the beginning of the service here and sharing those with us as well. All right. So, here's our schedule. Sunday worship, 10 o'clock Eastern time. Here we are. Very good. Then we have Monday story time at 6 p.m. So something for the kids. And there's always a craft with that too. So tune in Facebook Live Monday at 6. Tuesday, there's nothing. Wednesday, we have prayer time at 7 p.m. Then right after that on Wednesdays is The Chosen Movie Club. So we're on episode 2 this week. Watch The Chosen on YouTube. It's free. Watch it before Wednesday. We had like 7 or 8 people. It was real fun. We got together on Zoom. We'll send out the link to you. We'll email that to you, and then we can talk about what we saw on episode 2. Let's see, that takes us to Thursday, devotions with Jenny at 7 p.m., and then Friday fun for everyone, and then Saturday at noon, Dustin plays us some music while you're enjoying lunch. So that's our schedule, people, and we're just, we hear your comments, and we're so glad you're watching. We're so glad that we're staying connected. You know, it's going to be several months before we can meet together in a big room for worship. So this is what we're doing for now. It's so good to see you. We even, this week, too, we had a pet show for the little kids. We hopped on Zoom, they shared their dogs and their animals, and it was a blast, right? So we got some stuff cooked up like that. So just stay tuned and stay connected with us. So, oh man, look at that. We're up to 60 viewers already. That is fantastic. I'm gonna see if I missed everybody. We've got some people watching from Florida. Hello, Tishners. I see you there. Let's see, Mike Barnhart. Oh, there's a name I haven't heard for a while. He's he's an old high school friend of mine. Good to see you, Mike. The Scots are here again as well. Let's see who else. Angie Allen, good to see you in the house. Candace Smurr, we're watching. The Selbys, the Marshes. Trisha, oh, good grief. There's so many people. Good to see you, all right? So we're going to sing 2 songs today. Then we're going to get into, we'll share about online giving, how we do that. We're going to have another song. We're going to have a celebration Sunday, our prayer time. We're going to have a message about the revolutionary kingdom of God. And today is about the authority of Scripture. And sometimes people take Scripture out of context. That's not good. So we're going to talk about that today. And then we're going to end with some music today. But most importantly, we're so glad you're with us. Thank you for my team for being here. And let's just get into a time of worship. Turn up the volume because you're going to enjoy this music. Sing along, clap along, enjoy it. All right? We'll turn it over to Dustin and Mark.
The truth. So we just introduced this last week, and it felt like we didn't quite get enough of it yet. So the message in this song is so powerful, and for this time in everyone's life, I just want to believe that God has a plan, and He's going to make a way, because He's the way maker.
Never stop.
That is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Sing Waymaker.
You are Waymaker. So make a work of escape. Light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Alright, friends. Boy, if you were in the room with us, I cannot stay in my seat during that song. I can't. I'm drumming, I'm singing, it's powerful. Thank you. Thank you for that wonderful music this morning. So I want to say hi to a few more people here, and then we're going to talk about our online giving here. So the Anderson, Bill and Missy are watching, the Emmerichs are watching. Hello to the Howicks, Missy Knopp and family. The McLemore's, good to see you this morning. Laura, the Georges from down south somewhere. Lancaster, I think that's what. Good to see you guys this morning. Trisha Self, Piercy's. Hi, Riley. I see you, Riley. Thank you. Grace said Riley's here, too. They're watching together. Sue Slayton's and fam. I see you watching. The Walkers. Bosslers, hi, everyone. Good to see you. The Bows, the Fries, John Coates. John, I think you're from Nashville, Tennessee, right? Stick that in the, correct me if I'm wrong there, but I think so down there. Diane Basham, the Eric, Scott Campbell, I see you. Rissy, I see you. Glenna, my mom's watching. Hi, Mom, good to see you. And that reminds me, I told you wrong earlier. Next week is not Grad Sunday, it's Mother's Day. And get this, friends. Get this. Sit down for a second. Get this. I'm going to interview my mom for next Sunday. It's going to be a riot, okay? Yes. It's going to be an awesome Sunday. So I'm going to interview her, and I'll share that with you next Sunday. We're doing grads later in the month of May, so that's our schedule. So sorry about that. Nashville, yeah, John Coates, he got me back. He says, Nashville represent. Good to see you, my friends. So, all right, so our online giving friends, thank you, first of all, so for your generous giving throughout this entire time. It is wonderful. We continue to feed our healthcare workers. We continue, if you said it in the memo, if you say it's going to food bank or food, well, that's what we're doing with it. So thank you for helping people throughout this time. We know incomes have changed. We know people have lost jobs. We know food isn't as readily available as it was before. So we are making a difference, and we're doing that. We have Steve Walker. I know you're out there. Shoot me a text, Steve, so I can share about Food Pantry this week, okay? Shoot me that text, and I'll let people know here. Online giving, though, go to newwayumc.com right here in the window, newwayumc.com. There's an online options tab. Click on that, and you'll find the giving. And once you get there, you have three ways to give. There's actually four, but three on the website. You can give right through your bank account. You can give with a credit card. And then you can also text to give. You can set that up all right there as well. You do need to create an account, and that's for everyone's safety, okay? So create that account, get in there, and then you can do it. If you want something specifically, we have a future fund as we plan for the future. We have food as well, and then we just have our general offering as well. You can put whatever you want, however you want to divide that up in the memo section. You can do that. And also on our website, if you just like to write a check, stick it in the mail and send it in, our address, our post office box is on there. Okay, so that's what you can do. I'm writing down, I already have a full sheet of Celebration Sunday. During this next song, send me your prayer requests, send me your celebrations. I'm going to continue to write that down, and then I'll be back up to share those.
Yourself, do you thirst for a drink from the
So it's kind of neat, you're letting me know where you're watching from, and several of you are outside, like on a deck or on a porch. Man, what, on this beautiful day, to be able to be outside, to me, that takes worship to a whole new level, okay? Let me just tell you that, because now you're like sensing God's creation around you. And then you're hearing the music, you're singing, you know, you're praying. That is awesome. Congratulations. If you're able to do that, awesome. And we're inside. Maybe we'll move outside someday. I don't know. I'm not promising anything, all right? Not promising. But let me share with you. Let's see. Let's do who's watching first. Got a couple more here I want to share. Misty, I see you guys out there. Nick Winger, Mike Sears, good to see you. And check this out. Not only are we live on Facebook, friends, we're also live on YouTube. So I want to give a big shout out to my YouTube viewers. We have at least 20 people watching on YouTube as well. So thank you. Yeah.
So 10 on New Way Online.
Okay. Yeah, and we have we have YouTube Live, and we also have a New Way Online Church, newway.online.church platform that has a chat window also. So those that aren't on Facebook can still have that chatting experience. And my host today, let me tell you, my host, my niece Jenny is your host on Facebook Live, and my son Riley is on host on the New Way Online platform. So give a shout out to both of them. Hit the like button, that heart button a couple times, and let them know that to say thank you for doing that, and thank you for holding up those connections. All right, now let's get to some celebrations. We got some celebrations. I've got at least a full page here, if not more. So if I miss any, just keep putting it in the chat window, okay? Do that for me. So our friend Hannah Boatsman's 19th birthday is today. Happy birthday, Hannah. Check it out. I don't even know how this happens here. My dad and my best friend Mark share the same birthday, May 11th. That's crazy. That's crazy right there. Nick Winger will be 20. His birthday is on the 25th, I think, if I got that right. Melissa says...
No, his birthday is today and he's 25.
His birthday is today and he's 25. Thank you. I didn't think that was right when I read it, though, but I'm trying to get all these down. Melissa Seaford, May 10th, you got a birthday. Get this, Catherine McKee, little Catherine, is turning 1 on the 17th. Oh, man, what an exciting time that is. I've been seeing a lot of people, they do like these drive-by parades, honking horns, and somebody this week in Perry, I saw the police came by, the fire trucks, the ambulances, just made the kids' day. It was awesome. Pam Allen, Dustin's mom, his birthday's May 5th. And get this, not only that, they're also having 40th anniversary this month. Congratulations, that's on the 30th, holy cow. Connie Loy, her birthday's on May 2nd. Will Jewell, Will, and it's so good to see and hear that you guys are watching. Look at this, 83, he's gonna be 83 on May 15th. 83, congratulations. The Selby wedding anniversary is this month, May 31st. 6 years, Johnny? I think we're at 6 for them, right?
Yeah, that sounds good.
That sounds good. All right. It's enough to look. Johnny, my man Johnny's got a birthday, May 24th. Johnny, how old are you going to be?
35.
He's going to know you're not. Oh, my goodness, that hurts. Johnny's going to be 35. I met Johnny when he was 15, I think.
Yeah, that's 20 years ago.
Wow. Neither of us have aged at all. We look amazing. All right. Grossman's, they have a 9th anniversary on May 21st. Angie and Avon Allen, they have an 11-year anniversary on the 24th. My nephew Steven's birthday is on May 4th. Olivia's got a birthday on May 7th. Austin Forney, May 23rd. He turns 9 this year. And Chuck and Amber Anderson have an anniversary on the 19th. That is a ton of good stuff, isn't it? Let me see. Uh-oh, Brenda Lyon also said they have a 37th anniversary on the 7th. Yeah, we got Mark's birthday there. So the Lyons, 37 years. That is incredible. Let me get back to my Facebook feed here.
My code's birthday is...
Tara and I share our birthday too. Oh, okay, Don says that, Tara and Don, October 9th. Man, so many, goodness. I think I've got everybody here. Yeah, I think that's it. So again, if I missed it, just stick it in that chat window so everyone can celebrate along with you. So a lot of good stuff in May. Dustin, your mom's birthday is this month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tuesday night.
And they got an anniversary coming up too, so.
30th.
Oh, on the 30th. Yeah, 40 years.
40 years.
Amazing. That is incredible. Congratulations. All right, let's go into our prayer time here now, as we just sang, Oh, Come to the Altar. So I got some prayers to lift up. Just want to remind you, on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock, we've got live prayer time on our Facebook page. Jennifer leads that. So we have a lot of prayer requests. We just keep adding on to them. I have a few here, and if you have more, just go ahead and add them, okay? You can do that. First of all, I wanted to let you know, look through the chat window. 5 to 7, if you need food this week, this is for anybody in the area. If you need food from 5 to 7 on Tuesday, our food pantry is open. There's a phone number you have to call. Just give them a call, it's real simple. They take down your name and what to get. So what you do is you pull into the church, you pop your trunk, they drop it in the back, and then you head out. It's that simple. Please, take advantage of this, okay? If you need food, take advantage of this. We have so much food that we want to get it into the hands of the people that need it. Or if you know someone, please give them that phone number, okay? So we have that. All right, we have prayers for marriages to heal. For the state reopening, we heard some updates from DeWine this week. So there's a lot of concern on both issues, on opening it and maybe keeping it closed. So we got prayers there. People who are just struggling with this quarantine life, and not everybody, some people are just go out people, right? And some people are stay in people. So prayers for everyone there. And then, of course, there are unspoken prayers there as well. Let me just check here real quick. I think, things are looking good there. We do have the food listed again on the chat window and that phone number. So we're gonna go into a time of prayer. So no matter where you are, friends, just settle yourselves. If you're outside, if you're inside, and it's neat, because when we pray, and we'll do a time of silent prayer, just listen. If you're outside, you're gonna hear the birds. You can hear God talk to you through the birds and through the wind even. If you're inside, maybe you hear some of your kids' voices or you hear something, but God will speak to you. So let's go to God together. Oh God, we thank you for this time together. Even though we can't be with each other physically, we are still connected, and that connection happens through you. Oh God, we just sang a song about come to the altar. You've invited us, and here we are. And we have prayer requests. We have some heavy stuff on our hearts. We have some very exciting stuff on our hearts, too. And God, we just take a moment to lift those up to you. To those ones where we need comfort, we ask for comfort. To those situations where we're worried about, to give us peace and to celebrate with us in the excitements of birthdays and anniversaries and healings and everything that goes with that. And God, we just take a moment here silently to lift some prayers up to you. No matter where we are, no matter how we're doing it, we just take a moment and send our prayers to you. God, there's no greater place than we can be than to be at your altar. To be with you in conversation, in life. And God, we feel your presence. We feel your encouragement. We feel your love, your mercy, your grace in our lives. And God, help us to share that with someone this week. Someone that's struggling, someone who's afraid, who's upset, who's discouraged. That we can share your love and how you take care of us, how you are our foundation. Lord, we lift all this up to you. We lift it up in the name of your Son, Jesus, whom you love so much, he sent to die just for us. It's in the name of Jesus we do pray. Amen. So we are in a series called Revolutionary Kingdom. We looked at Jesus and this message, this radical message he brought before Easter. Now after Easter, we're kind of looking at, what does that mean? We play this all out, just as Jesus asked us to. How does that change this world? How does that change our community, our family, and our friends? So that's what we're looking at. Lately, I've been pulling out some feel-good moments. These are just some different videos that kind of go out and people see them and they send them to me. If you see one, send them, right? Send me as many as you can so I can have a whole bunch to share here. But today's feel-good moment, so this week or last week, I'd sent out to the Perry local staff, if anyone wanted to be part of this John Bon Jovi video and to sing it, to rock out to It's My Life, remember that song? So I put that together and it blew up on Facebook, 20,000 views. We even ended up on Channel 3 just a couple nights ago. They had that on there and they shared a clip and it was pretty exciting. So I'm going to play a little bit of that for you. Johnny, I don't know if I'll play the whole thing, so just I'll watch it here. But let me play a little bit of this here. So what I did was I sent everyone a track and they had put in their headphones and they either played or they sang along. Some people just danced and then I think it came out pretty fun. So there, take a look at this.
Everybody, it's mine.
My heart is like an open highway.
Facebook. Also, if you're on YouTube, just search It's My Life, Perry Staff. Over 1,000 views on YouTube there. You can watch the whole thing. And so that's our feel-good moment of the week. So if you have something, please send it in to me so I can share those. All right, last week we talked about this countercultural kingdom of God, and it is alive and well. If we're living our life for Jesus, that means we are, in a lot of ways, we're pushing upstream against the rest of the world. But we're doing what Jesus taught us to do, and we're living life the way he taught us to live it. So today I'm going to talk about kingdom authority, and what that means is, like, where do we get our direction for life from? Where does that come from, okay? And so kind of asking, so if we take that idea and like, where do you get your information? Think about your news, okay? That's where I want to start with. And because that has changed in so many ways just recently. Unfortunately, we see local newspapers, even TV stations, closing down more almost every day, especially newspapers, because more people are getting their news and information online, all right? So look at this. Facebook continues to dominate as the most common social media site for news by Americans. Roughly over 40% of people are getting their news from Facebook. That's a little concerning, friends, because just because it's on Facebook doesn't mean it's true, right? Or how about this phrase? You've heard this. If it's on the internet, it must be true. No, it's not. And this is what concerns me, because when we talk about kingdom living, we've got to understand and know the Word of God, the Bible, and how it applies to our life. And there is so much misinformation out there, it's easy to get tricked, okay? So I want to talk about some tips and tricks of and some websites at the end, too, that I want you to look at this week to really make sure that you understand. Because this is my bottom line. If you're listening to someone talk, if you're reading something and Scripture is involved and it doesn't settle right inside your heart, it's probably not right. It's very easy to grab one word, one line out of a scripture passage and use it in a way that's not meant to be used. That is not kingdom authority. Kingdom authority is looking at the entire picture, looking at the entire Bible, and seeing how it works to shape our lives, okay? So, I had a funny story here. This whole idea, if it's on the internet, it must be true. Meet my dad. Check out my dad there. So he's got a birthday this week. This is a rare picture of them both smiling together, so it's pretty cool. I don't know, this was a year or two ago. Me and my dad were out in our driveway and we were working, and we were just doing something I don't even remember. Maybe he was just talking. Some guy pulls up in a truck and gets out and he goes, "Are you Kenny Brown?" My dad's like, "Yeah." He goes, and this guy, I swear, he said, "I thought you had died." And my dad looked at him and was like, "Nope." I'm like, "Yep, he's right here. He's not dead." And this guy, he would not let it drop. It's almost like he didn't believe my dad. He's like, "Are you sure? Because, yeah, I heard from several people that you had passed away like 6 months ago." My dad's like, "Nope. I don't know." But you see how that happens. Word gets around, and it's just not true. You know, in some ways, I call us a headline society. Because here's what happens. I know it. I've seen it. I probably even am guilty of it. You see a headline, and that's all you go off of. You don't read the rest of the story. We don't dig in to make sure, is this a legitimate news site? There are some satirical websites out there. They're absolutely hilarious, but they're satire. They're not true, but people will pass them off as being true. Even, look at this, Dewey defeats Truman. Way back then that the paper had it, it's not true, right? It's not right. So, you know what, it was fun. I had to look this up here. I had to. Some bulletin bloopers. Because just because it's in print, people, doesn't necessarily mean it's true. Look, this sign says, "Don't let worries kill you, let the church help." Okay, I've got a few more of these. Now, when you laugh, hit that laughy button, because these are just too funny. All right, so these are right out of church bulletins that obviously were misprinted, right? The ladies' Bible study will be held Thursday morning at 10. All ladies are invited to lunch in the fellowship hall after the BS is done. Now, I got to tease my mom, because she always totally got me off guard the first time. We had a Bible study, and she texts me, "So when is the BS tonight?" I'm like, "The BS?" And then she replies back, "Yeah, the Bible study. When is that going on tonight?" Oh, I see a laughing face. Oh, man. So when I saw that, I had too much. All right, here we go. Low self-esteem support group will meet Thursday at 7, from 7 to 8:30. Please use the back door. Oh, come on now. Come on now, right? Oh, geez. Another one. Here we go. Bulletin bloopers. Ushers will eat latecomers. Oh, don't be late. Don't be late. I think they mean seat latecomers. All right, here we go. During the absence of our pastor, we enjoyed the rare privilege of hearing a good sermon when J.F. Stubbs supplied our pulpit. Oh, that's just sticking it to the man right there. Oh, geez. All right, let's see one more here I got for you. Ready? Ladies, don't forget the rummage sale. It is a good chance to get rid of those things not worth keeping around the house. Bring your husbands. Oh, my goodness. Too much, right? Oh, bulletin bloopers. And you know, then I kind of got to thinking, and I was actually talking with my daughter Grace about this. I normally throw around my messages during the week, and I said, well, what would it look like if today's headlines, which aren't always true, existed during the times of Jesus? You with me on this? Existed during the time. So we threw around a couple of them, and look at this. So we took, it was the story, but we rewrote the headline, right? Jesus takes food from little boy. Right? But instead, you know, Matthew 14, Jesus feeds 5,000 is one of his miracles. Jesus kills pigs. 1,000 pigs dead. But you see, in Matthew 5, Jesus rids the man of demons. The demons left the body and into the pigs. So he saved that man's life. Right? Jesus sinks a fisherman's boat could be the headline. Jesus didn't sink a fisherman's boat. In John 21, he said, throw your net on the other side. He had so much fish that he couldn't bring them all in. And then we just have the headline, Jesus dies. And we know, though, in Matthew 27 and Matthew 28, Jesus was crucified. But then we also read about his resurrection from the grave. You see, friend, there is authority in the Bible that we got to make sure we understand. And sometimes you'll see people twist scripture. And this is where you gotta listen to your heart and your gut. Twisted scripture, like what I did there with the video. Okay, good. Twisted scripture. So it's, and there are groups out there, and so this is like the importance of understanding and getting into your Bible every day and knowing that our authority comes from that Bible when we read through it. Because here's some, and I looked up, it's way too easy too, because if you look up twisted scripture, there's thousands of results of what people have used. Here's one that says in 1 Corinthians 14, it says, women should remain silent in churches. They are not allowed to speak, but must be in submission, as the law says. Yet we see Jesus using women as critical parts of his ministry throughout his life. But people can use this to say women should be submissive, right? Ephesians 6:5, when you twist the scripture, it says, slaves, obey your earthly masters in respect and fear and with sincerity of heart, just as you would obey Christ. It's saying slavery is okay. That's what people twist the scripture as when it's not okay. That's not what Jesus was about. Proverbs 23:13-14 says, do not withhold discipline from a child. If you punish them with the rod, they will not die. Punish them with the rod and save them from death. It talks about discipline. It doesn't talk about child abuse. You see the difference, friends? Twisted scripture. But our Bible and our Jesus is way different than all those. It's about kingdom authority. It's about when you read the entire story that God speaks to you, because those are God's words talking to you. So look at the whole story. Some, you know, it's called, I think the term is called proof texting, when you take one line out of an entire scripture and you hang your hat on that. That's not how the Bible is meant to be read. That's not kingdom authority. That's being selective. That's pulling the scripture out for your gain and not for the entire story. Let's check out this story. John 8, starting at verse 2. This here shows us, when you take all this scripture and we look at it, it gives us the life and the trueness of what Jesus and God were about. So at dawn, Jesus appeared again in the temple courts, where all the people gathered around him, and he sat down to teach them. Even the teachers of the law and the Pharisees, they were there. But look at this, they brought a woman caught in adultery. All right? They made her stand before the group and said to Jesus, teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. Now, what do you say? This right here, this is what I'm talking about when it comes to kingdom authority. Let's look at Jesus' response. You see, they were using this question as a trap in order to have a basis for accusing him. But Jesus bent down and he started to write on the ground with his finger. I would love to know what he was writing. because he was about to, you know, Jesus, he's doing his thing, get down, and he starts writing. And they kept on questioning him, and then he straightened up, and he said to them, let anyone of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her. And then he stooped down and continued writing on the ground. Verse 9 says, at this, those who heard began to go away, one at a time. The older ones first, until only Jesus was left with the woman still standing there. And Jesus straightened up and he asked her, woman, where are they? Has no one has no one condemned you? He says, no, sir, not one. Then neither do I. I do not condemn you. Jesus declared, go now and leave your life of sin. Now that's the story. You see how that scripture could have been twisted. But when we read the entire story and we see the response of Jesus in love and forgiveness, peace, grace, mercy, that's the Jesus. That's kingdom authority. You see, Jesus is the living word of God, revealing infinite love, love that never ends, and patience with us that never ends. Look at how he dealt with that situation. You see, my friends, when you get into kingdom authority, let me tell you a few things. Jesus is love. He's not hate. Jesus is peace. He's not anger. Jesus is joy, not sorrow. Jesus is kind. He's not mean. Jesus is forgiving. He's not judgmental. My friends, it's about kingdom authority. Our Bible, when you read through your Bible, not even start to finish, when you just get into it and you read your stories, let those stories speak to you. Read the entire thing. When you hear something that's like, that doesn't sound right to me, you're probably right. Investigate it. I've got a couple websites here I want to share with you that can help with this investigation. Because as you go throughout your week, I want you to find the scripture. Maybe one that's been kind of bugging you, just doesn't sound right. I want you to dig into it and find out why it doesn't sound right to you. Because you're going to be right. So two websites here to leave you with. BibleGateway.com. This is the same as the YouVersion app I talked about. It has almost every translation of the Bible in it. And sometimes for me, I kind of stick with one translation, but then maybe sometimes I got to switch it up to kind of really understand something, because sometimes translations will speak to you in various ways. So you might not get it in one, but another one. And when you combine those two, then it clicks with you. Here's another one, too, that every time I mention with this, I get a lot of people saying this is an excellent website. It's called blueletterbible.org, blueletterbible.org. So this is a very much more research-based website where call up scripture, and when it does, you can choose exactly what translation stuff, but then like different words are highlighted in it, and you can click on those words. If you're interested in the Hebrew, the Greek, the Latin of these words, click on it, and it'll tell you, and it might define it in a different way for you that, like, okay, now I see why they're using that word in the scripture, and then it begins to connect. Then your kingdom authority of what the Bible has for us in our lives makes sense and becomes alive in our life. So those two were websites, Bible Gateway and blueletterbible.org. You see, being part of the revolutionary kingdom, we have a guidance. We have a guidance in our Bible. And there's so much information out there, so many bloopers, so many headlines that don't tell the whole story, that we need to be grounded in what our Bible says and know what our Bible says. And just reading it every day, a little bit, a lot, it doesn't matter. But it will speak to you, and it will clear up this whole picture. So let's have a word of prayer over this. God, we thank you for this time together. And God, the Bible, sometimes it's so hard to sit down and read. But then when we do, it becomes so alive to us. It answers our questions. It helps us through situations. And sometimes, God, we hear things that just don't sound right. Help us to know that the authority in the Bible, and to look at it, to dig deep in it, to read it, to share it with people, to discuss it with people. Because the more we do that, the more we learn about you, God. The Bible is your word, and it speaks to us. Let something amazing speak to us this week, God. We're excited of what you're going to do. Excited to learn something new through your word. Be with us, God, through this uncertain time when we're looking for something to grasp onto, to hold onto, to give us a little bit of foundation in our life, God. Help us to make sure we turn to the Bible. Turn to those stories of comfort of hope and of joy. To look at that story of those people wanting to stone this person, but then Jesus comes along and says, "Yeah, if you're so good, throw the first stone." How that shares His love with us, His grace and His mercy. And friends, if you're watching, you need this grace and mercy, and you've been struggling with life, Jesus says, "Let me in. Let me into your heart." You just say, "God, I want you in my heart. Jesus, come into me. Fill me up. I'm tired of the way I'm living, and I want to live life for you." If you said that prayer, then hallelujah. Hallelujah and amen to that. You're going to experience life in a whole new way. In a way of excitement. In a way of comforted. A way of knowing that you'll never, ever be alone. Life of hope and joy and comfort. And God, we thank you for that. Thank you for everyone watching today. Thank you for helping us share today's message and service and music and prayer time. And just the connections we have together. We can sense everyone together through you, God. And we thank you for that. Be with us. Keep us safe. Keep us healthy. Give us wisdom, God. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. All right, friends, now listen, we got one more song to share with you, and then we're going to keep the chat window open for another 5 minutes or so just to say hi and bye and all that good stuff. So take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Reach out to somebody this week. Send them a note. Send them some flowers. Send them a pizza. You know, I don't know. Do something to show people that you care and share the love of God with someone this week. All right, got one more song to share with you, and I'm going to hop on the chat window and say hi to everyone.
Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come. This is my confidence, you never circumstance. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness.
Woo!